All right, so continuing on from where we left off, yeah. If you leave an Israelite woman, she's supposed to leave your house with nothing. She's not supposed to take any more, any of the children. She's not supposed to get anything off you in terms of alimony. She's supposed to leave back to her father's house. It's back to where she came from. Because you see, a woman is her father's possession as long as she's unmarried. And then when she becomes married, yeah, she then becomes the property of her husband. But as you saw from the video that I played earlier, that harlot clearly had no father in her life, was more than likely raised in a house full of other women, harlots, of course, and probably had a harlot skank for her mother as well. Her mother's probably got different daughters by different men, and I can guarantee you that, or maybe even sons, but different children by different men. I can guarantee you that the average so-called black woman, man, goes through the cycle of being a skank throughout her 20s, gets to about 30 with numerous different children, maybe just one if she's lucky, and then realizes that shit, I need to settle down. Then she gets married to some simp and puts on a white dress to try and personify purity, where really she's had cock run through her from when she was about 15. Hey, man. You women are all a bunch of sluts, and I don't care how this sounds, yeah. And I know a lot of you simps, especially you Captain Saber hoes, are gonna come with that. But your mama black. Hey, listen, man. At the end of the day, the Most High God, yeah, the power of the Bible said our women were gonna be harlots. He didn't lie, man. Our women are harlots, complete sluts. Yeah, but it's all good though, because you're gonna get yours. Isaiah chapter 32, verse 9 says, "Rise up, ye women that are at ease," which basically means fix the fuck up. "Hear my voice, ye careless daughters, give ear unto my speech." Why? Verse 10 explains, "Many days and years shall ye be troubled, ye careless women." But you see these women out here, they don't give a fuck, man. They come out here dressed scandalous as hell, you know, titties popping out practically, going out partying, doing all kind of wickedness, throwing themselves about, jumping from man to man. But then you try and advance on them and literally just do, you know, the right, you know, do like deal with like one of our ancient forefathers, you know, if she's not betrothed, you do what you do. Hey, man, you're gonna be under the jail, man. That's why the scripture says all things are lawful, but not all things are expedient, man. These women are out here literally dressed indecently, man, indecent exposure. They're not allowed to really be out here literally three quarters naked. But guess what? Esau endorses that, man. You'll see these whores out here in the middle of February when it's freezing cold, wearing next to nothing. Because these hoes don't get cold, bruv. They got that radiator box, like the brother on Mark in the London camp said, that radiator box, that central heating box. You get me? Out here in the fucking freezing cold in February with their legs showing, titties out. Because these women are harlots with no fucking shame, and that's all good. It says, "Many days and years shall you be troubled, ye careless women, for the vintage shall fail, the gathering shall not come. Tremble, ye women that are at ease. Be troubled, ye careless ones. Strip you and make you bare, and get sackcloth upon your loins." Hey, when that time of Jacob's trouble comes, there ain't gonna be no electricity to do up your hair with those hair extensions. Those weave shops are gonna be shut down, yeah? So, a lot of you women out here, you ain't gonna have that makeup. A lot of you women out here look like a completely different person when you slap on some makeup, but you out here acting like you brand new. When that time comes, man, of Jacob's trouble, when those makeup stores are shut, when you ain't gonna be able to do your hair up or get no weave, and you're exposed for the ugly gremlins that you really are, a lot of men are literally gonna use you as tools for food. You might watch The Road, Booker Eli. A man might trade you for two bottles of water or whatever the fuck. At the end of the day, all you gonna be are women again. But you, I mean, let me not even say that. You ain't gonna be women, because you ain't women now. You just gonna be beasts. You gonna go back to being women in the kingdom of heaven, you Israelite women, of course. And the rest of the women are gonna be, of the other nations, are going to be subservient under you, but they're still going to be women. But hey, man, none of this beastly behavior, none of that shit about talking about big chains and guano. That dumb nigga woman gonna get burnt to a crisp in the fire, man, and she gonna come back with everlasting shame and contempt, thinking, "Fucking hell, that was me." Hey, serious, man. A lot of you women are pieces of shit. That's why me personally, when I deal with women, I look at you like you're beneath me. Why? Because you are. I don't care if the society puts you on a pedestal. I don't believe in that, man. I'll play the game, but you know, at the end of the day, I know in my heart of hearts that you know that you're beneath me, man. And all of you women know that, man. Women are nothing but a toy, man. You just fuck around with them and tell them what they need to hear, man. At the end of the day, that you ain't gotta show no woman no respect. You show a woman respect and she starts to disrespect you automatically, man. And it's the truth. I've been through it. You try and show a woman. I've been in situations where I came some so you know semi disrespectful to women, but it's not disrespectful. It was just being a man and being assertive, and they loved me for it. Then I tried to switch it up, tried to be nice to them, and all of a sudden they switched up on me on some yeah, you know, I can't really fuck with you no more, you know. So at the end of the day, fuck it, man. These women are sluts, man. Don't be going out your way for these hoes. All of these women, man, they don't matter where you meet them, man. I'm telling you, they're all harlots, bruv. From when you've got a slut like Cardi B going number one in the, I mean, I don't know where she went. Near enough number one where she had about 3, 4 songs in the charts, and these women all emulate her, from the college hoes to the ratchet skanks on the corner to the fucking escort bitches fucking every Tom, Dick and Harry. Hey, when you've got an ex-prostitute, yeah, in the charts, and women are trying to push her up like she's the next, you know. I mean, Rosa Parks was off, but you know, like, you know, at least she represented something. Now these women are on some, yeah, she, you know, she just represents freedom of sexuality. And she, I mean, come on, man. When, you know, from when women are into Nicki Minaj and Cardi B are their go-to people for female empowerment, and Kim Kardashian, you know that the society is fucked, man. Completely fucked. And these women, you try and teach them any righteousness, they gonna turn around and slap it in your face, man. 'Cause at the end of the day, they know you can't do nothing about it. Hey, women are literally the opposite of men in this society. Women are your enemy in this society, man. You just go get the box and you keep it moving, man. Don't be falling in love with these hoes, man. I read that in Sirach earlier. Don't give your substance unto a harlot, and all of these women are harlots, man. A woman, even in her righteous state, is a servant, and you don't love your servant like Apostle Gabbar once said. You know, you might have a good servant, and you let your servant know you appreciate him, you know. But in the same way, you have a good woman, you let a good woman know you appreciate her, but you ain't trying to, you know, show her that, you ain't trying to make her your equal, you know, give her a piece of your heart or whatever the fuck. At the end of the day, women can't control themselves, man. They're emotional based creatures. They love you today, they hate you tomorrow. Hey, King Solomon had 1,000 women, and he did an experiment and said he found one man out of 1,000, but out of a woman he found none, and he was a king, man. So how much more us? You know, we ain't got nothing to nothing for these women to aspire to in the world. You heard that, bitch. They want big chains and guala. So don't be feeling no type of way if you ain't getting no woman on this side, brothers, man. 'Cause at the end of the day, they ain't women, bro. They beasts, man. Fucking beasts. And you know, I've seen it, man. Some of these women be up in men's faces. Let a bitch get up in my face like that. See, I mean, listen, I'm never gonna go there. But hey, man, these proud ass women, they gonna get taught a lesson, man. This is Micah 7:10. It says, "Then she that is mine enemy, yeah, rightfully so, enemy, adversary, shall see it." And what's she gonna see? A lot of these women out here, man, that we prophesy against, that camp even, that try to come up against us talking about, why you got horns on Jesus, when it clearly says Jesus Christ, if you know, for verbatim, for edification sense, is not a white man. Yeah, they don't even read the sign. They just see their savior. They just see their big white daddy, you know, their big pasty cracker Edomite daddy on a poster, and they're looking at it like, why are you doing that to Jesus for? You know, all of these women that come up against us saying, yeah, you man ain't right, you should go back to the Christian church and etc. etc. Hey, man, she that is my enemy shall see it, and shame shall cover her, which said unto me, where is the Lord Jehovah? Where is the Lord thy God? Mine eyes shall behold her. Now shall she be trodden down as the mire of the streets. That don't sound pretty, man. Basically, you women that are out here trying to doubt the prophets, trying to come back against the prophets, trying to send men against the prophets, trying to say that we ain't credible sources, man. Guess what? Yahabah Shem Yahushua said, "You shall be trodden down as the mire of the streets in that day, man." Women are going to be getting killed, totally decimated and destroyed. And it's a beautiful thing, because a lot of you women deserve death, man. And it's about time a lot of you started getting it, because I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you, man, you women, man, death is needed, man. Ezekiel 9:4. And the Lord Yahabah Shem Yahushua said unto him, speaking about the angel, "Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set up a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for the abominations that be done in the midst thereof." Why is it men? What the Lord also said in the New Testament, Yahushua said, the congregation of his followers are men, because men are the ones that the Most High deals with, man. The chain of command is the man, is Yahweh, the father, then Yahweh Shai, then the Israelite man, the Israelite woman, children on down, man. The Most High deals with men, a congregation of men. Obviously, yes, you had prophetesses, you had female prophets in the scriptures, and female figureheads that did things, and important women, but hey, man, predominantly and for the most part, the Most High deals with men. Yeah, straight into the point. Anyway, it says, and to the others he said in mine hearing, so anyone that didn't get the mark of exemption, similar to in the Passover, you know, but this mark of exemption is the understanding and the name of Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So it says, unto the others he said in mine hearing, yeah, whoever didn't get it, go you after him through the city and smite. Let not your eye spare, neither have ye pity. No prisoners, man. No mercy, no prisoners. Slay utterly old and young, no discrimination, both maids and little children and women. Yeah? Women are going to die, man. And you see abominations like that, bitch. She needs to die five deaths, man. I'm telling you, man. Go fucking hell, bruv. I don't know what the fuck that shit is, man. She looks like a Pokemon. Yeah? She needs to go, man. Her and that New Era hat. Of hair that she got on her head. It says, slay utterly maids and young, old and young, both maids and little children, but come not near upon any man whom is the mark, and begin in my sanctuary. Then they began at the ancient men which were before the house. Now, that's going to happen again, man. Israel as a whole is going to get decimated, totally destroyed, because at the end of the day, our people, man, are willingly wicked. You see, the black woman. Yeah, which is what she is, the black hole, I should call her. The black hole is out here leading our people to destruction, leading simps down the rabbit hole to hell, man. Oh, man. Because at the end of the day, man, these women, man, they ain't fit to rule, man. But you go to any so-called black empowerment, and these women are out there, man, trying to look like they're the center of attention, trying to be the center of attention, trying to lead something. You just need to lay back and spread your legs and shut the fuck up, man. Because at the end of the day, like I said earlier, if a woman splits with a man, the man keeps the child, the son, or the daughter, and the woman goes back to her father's ownership to see if the father can then marry her off again. And if not, then she stays single, man, out back in her father's house, but she goes back and does some enterprise to help her father. Most of these bitches out here don't even know who their father is, and they're trying to keep the father of their child in their life. They're trying to milk you for whatever you got, man. And I've known people in the world that that's happened to. So what are you harboring? Shimmy, I wish I had that shit ain't happened to me, because I don't know how I'd react to that. Hey, man, but guess what? It's the curses. And it says it right here in Deuteronomy 28 and 56, the tender and delicate woman among you, which would not venture to set the sole of her foot upon the ground for delicateness. So imagine that, yeah. Imagine beastly bitches like this monkey over here, if the video will show, yeah? Back in the day, the Israelite woman was actually so dainty, so sacred and so pure that she wouldn't actually even venture to set her foot upon the ground, yeah? For delicateness. Imagine that. So the black woman actually used to be dainty. Imagine that. Monkeys like this, I'm going to see if the video plays, used to be dainty. But let me quickly read this real quick and I'll come back to it. So, would not set the sole of her foot on the ground for delicateness and tenderness. Her eyes shall be evil towards the husband of her bosom, and towards her son, and towards her daughter, and toward her young one that cometh out from between her feet, and towards her children which she shall bear. Hey, man, it's the truth, man. These black women don't give a fuck about their kids. That's why they're always out there having one daughter push the second daughter on the pram. Or the youth big enough to be walking, but they just don't give a fuck. They just have it in the pram any fucking way. Or they walking like, you know, about like 20 meters in front of their child, and the child's just running behind them screaming, mommy, mommy, could be kidnapped at any point in time. They don't give a fuck. There's going to be a time of Jacob's trouble, man. And the scripture does, and Yahweh Shai himself said, and the scripture says off what he said, woe to them that give suck in those days, because those martial law shoots going to be out here, man, hunting Jake. And if you're a woman breastfeeding, if you're a woman that's got infants and children, hey, man, it's going to be real for you. God, not only are you going to have to suffice for your own food and your own survival, you're going to have to watch over them also. But guess what it says, continuing on from verse 57, it says, for she shall eat them for the want of all things, secretly in the siege and straitness, wherewith thine enemy shall distress thee in thy gates. Now, something similar to this happened in 70 AD, man, where, that's referred to as the Roman-Jewish Wars, where the Romans came up against our people, man. That legit happened, man. The Israelite woman was out there eating her babies, man. It's not a fucking joke. The same thing is going to happen again. A lot of these Israelite women are going to be out here, man, eating their children, sacrificing their children for whatever they can to survive. Bitches like her are going to have that proud look, smirk, taken right off her face. Look at that shit. You mean to tell me that's a woman? You mean to tell me that's a Sarah of Israel, a queen, like you black unconsciousness niggas like to say? This shit? Come on, man. Come on, man. I can't wait for bitches like this to die. I really can't. I don't even know if the video's gonna play.
At the end of the day, I don't care if you think I'm a gold digger. Like, I like what I like. I like the big daddies, yeah? I like the money makers, yeah? I like the one with the Rolex, yeah? With the big...
I ain't even gonna play this shit again. But that's what you think is the queen of Israel? There ain't gonna be no queens in Israel. I'm gonna tell you that now. Yeah, and I know you black unconscious niggas are watching this video going crazy. Like, what? He dissing the queen. You motherfuckers got that beehive mentality. You get me? You want to protect the black woman at all costs, even if it costs you your life. But guess what, man? Oh, man. These black, so-called black women are not like the ancient women of old. You see, you read 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 1, and it says, for after this manner, in the old time, the holy women also, who trusted in the Most High, adorned themselves, being in subjection to their own husbands. Let's see what the word subjection means, man, so we can get a better understanding for you stupid motherfuckers. The word there is from the Greek.
Strong's G, 5293. Hupatasso. Hupotasso,
yeah? And it says to subjection, yeah? This is the word subjection. It's hupotasso in the Greek, to arrange under, to subordinate, to subject, put in subjection, to subject oneself, obey, to submit to one's control, to yield to one's admonition or advice. So basically, to take orders. You think monkeys like this are going to take orders?
Yeah, I like that. That's my type. So if you got a problem with it, that's your business. At the end of the day, I know I make my money, innit? I make gola, okay? I got peas of my own, yeah? But I want a nigga that gets it, yeah? I want new little fucking send-outs, yeah? The boys that get sent to the shop, yeah? Or the middleman.
She needs a bullet to the face, a shotgun to the face, I'll say. Straight to the point. Damn, devil, yeah? You think you put bitches like that are gonna submit themselves to you? God damn, man. That harlot gonna take your shit. She gonna take more than half. She gonna take 75, 80, maybe even 95%. And she gonna leave you, man. Look at Emmanuel Abue, man. That nigga married an Edomite. And he still got bit. Hey, man, that's not a joke. The scripture says here in verse 6 up regarding the old woman, even a Sarah obeyed Abraham, calling him Lord, whose daughters you are, as long as you do well and are not afraid with any amazement. Amen. Amen. And you know, it tells you, of course, in verse 7 that husbands also have to honor their wives. That's rightfully so, man. You know, at the end of the day, you know, you give your wife the due diligence, you know, that you do the husband's duty, you know, you plant the seed, you water it, you know, you look after her, the family, you know, you provide. But at the end of the day, man, you are supposed to be giving the woman control over your substance. 1 Corinthians 11 and 3 onwards down tells you, man, that, you know, that head of every man is Yahweh Shai, and the head of every woman is the man, man. It's straight into the point. Colossians also 3 and 18 tells you that women are supposed to subject themselves, man. Hey, I mean, 1 Corinthians 14 and 34 tells you that a woman is supposed to keep silent in the churches, man. They ain't even allowed to talk. She's the type of bitch to go suck a dick on Saturday and go to church on Sunday, which is all vanity any fucking way. Yeah? You know, I mean, like, these women need to keep their mouth shut. But obviously they ain't going to, because true to the curses, man, they're going to stay wicked. But it's all good. Your destruction soon cometh. I mean, I don't even want to put the spotlight on no hoes. and my phone's about to bug out, so I'm just gonna leave it there and say the so-called black woman for the most part is gonna be destroyed. Yeah. And hey man, at the end of the day, man, you don't need the black woman. The black woman is just a vessel, man. Yeah, all she is an incubator. As long as you got an Israelite man, the seed of Israel will always maintain. The black woman is just an incubator. And right now, man, she ain't a black. She is a black portal. She's a black hole. She ain't a woman. She's a black portal, man. Bitches like this monkey, they gonna get destroyed, man. They gonna catch flames, man. Don't think that these harlots are gonna be saved just cause they're women, man. Her weave, her titties, her stinky ass vagina, they all gonna burn. And she gonna be hoping that in them Ray-Bans that she copped one of them fucking baller shot callers that she apparently deals with saves her from the blast, man. But hey, she gonna die. Yeah, she gonna be trodden down as the mayor in the streets. I hope all of her exes run into her and murder her ass, man. Because that's what you so-called black women deserve. I don't care how you feel. Yahaba Shimi Hawashai, Abad Babao, man. Destroy these wicked women. Yeah, Shalom Akyam. Don't ever trip over these women. They're all harlots, man. And we deserve a lot better. And we're going to get a lot better soon come in the kingdom. There's good women out there, man. Like Yahaba Shimi Hawashai, the Most High himself is going to bestow unto us. Stay strong, Akyam. Shalom. Shalom.